is that the nature of God is in you. And they're responding to the nature of God. We adjure you in the name of Jesus, whom Paul preaches, that you would do whatever it is. And they said, now we know Paul. We know Paul, and we know Jesus. But we don't know who you are. And they beat him out the door. And beat their clothes off him. And they used all the right names in the name of Jesus. They said, by whom Paul preached. But they didn't get the same response because they didn't have the nature of God.
My God.
Demons are shouting to us. We went out and we wow, they returned with joy. See, the most amazing thing happened. See, when we got out there, we saw that demons were subject to us in your name. Subject to, yes, of course. Satan has already fallen from the sky. But don't just rejoice at that, rejoice that your name has been written in the book. You have access to my nature. You're not just using my name. You have my nature. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost gives you my nature.
Yes.
You try. You think it's because you say, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke you. No, you don't have the nature of the Holy Spirit. No. That's why the demon turned around and socks you, knocks you out. Now, go to 2 Peter. Are you there? 2 Peter, and I'm done. 2 Peter. We got to learn how to live now that Pentecost is over.
Yes.
2 Peter chapter number 1, verse 2, grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. Here it is. As his divine power, that's the Holy Spirit, has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and by virtue, by which have been given to us exceeding great and precious promises, that through these great and precious promises, you now have become a partaker of his divine nature. Having escaped the corruption that is in this world, the lust of the eye, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. You've escaped it. You've escaped it because of your nature. The divine power, which is the word dunamis, is the same power that he promised you in Acts chapter number 1 and verse 8, that ye shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses of me in Jerusalem. You shall be witnesses. You shall become my duplicate model. You are now my witness. If I walk out of the room, and I did this a few weeks ago, Paul allowed me to get away, and I'm still grateful. But I left my witness.
Yeah.
My duplicate was here. And if you close your eyes, you can hear the same verbiage. And if you open your eyes, you can look and say, oh my Lord, that is her witness. And then others came up, and the reason you could receive them is because they are my witnesses.
Yeah.
They have been duplicated in my image. So you can receive them because you know the sign that's in them is the same sign that's in me. So you didn't have no problem. So you're going to be my witnesses because I'm going to put in you the same thing God put in me. And I'm going to give you
The same power. The same power that raised me from the dead. I'm going to allow you to be a partaker of that power. And that power is going to reproduce in you my nature. And you'll get the same results that I got. Now
thank
that's
you, Lord.
The power of Pentecost.
Yes.
After Pentecost.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Is the power to be just like God. The power to get the same results. The power to walk in a room and change an atmosphere.
Yes.
I've been invited to a couple places this week for meetings. They said, we just want you in the room. I said, oh, really? Yeah, we just want you in the room. I said, well, you know, I'm busy. I got things to do. I don't like all these meetings with pastors and all. I got things to do. I got other fish to fry and biscuits to bake. I'm busy. But can you just come by? We just want you in the room. See, that's presence.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's not anointing. That's presence.
Yes.
We want your presence in the room. When people want your presence in the room, when people want your nature, they believe that if things are wrong, you'll make it right.
Yeah.
If things are incomplete, you'll bring the solution.
Right.
Bishop, can you just stop that? That's attraction. That's the law of attraction.
Yes.
That is the divine nature of God. If people are not attracted to you, check to see if you're filled with the Holy Spirit. Because the deposit of the Holy Ghost in your life will recreate the same thing in you that it created in Jesus. And let me tell you something. It's on all the time. You can be in dinner. You can be at work. You can be on the bus, you can be on a plane. I sit on the plane, for whatever the reason, I'm minding my own business. Maybe the church paid for me a coach ticket, I'm sitting there, coach, I'm minding my own business. And I hear over the loudspeaker, Corletta Vaughn, please turn on your button. Beep. Are you Ms. Vaughn? Yes. Please come to first class. Okay.
Yeah.
You check in your bags, and the sky cap says, would you like for me to bring a chair? I care for you to sit down. It's the divine nature. Don't get this confused with the anointing.
Yeah.
The anointing is just the power of attorney to get jobs done. But the Holy Ghost comes to give you his divine nature. My time is up. Come on, stand up. Praise God. Hallelujah. Come on, stand up on your feet and give God praise for the word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you tonight for the promise of the Holy Spirit in our lives to recreate in us the power that you gave Jesus.
Yes.
That same power that raised Jesus from the dead now quicken me in my mortal body. I do give you praise. I do give you glory. That nature confuses me with you. That circumstances confuses me with you. That things that won't line up when I show up, it thinks that I'm you. And God, you're all right with that. I am your witness. I am the manifested presence of who you are in the earth. And as you are in the heavens, so am I in the earth. God, help us to believe.
Yes.
Help us to receive it.
Yes.
Help us to do it every day of our lives by the power of your Holy Ghost. And we thank you for it. Come on, clap your hands. I gotta practice his presence.
Yeah.
Amen. When my personality wants to happen, I gotta wait and say, all right, Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
I need you to do what God would do, right?
Yeah.
If I handle it, I'm gonna tear it up.
Yeah.
And I may never get a chance to correct. get things up so badly that you never get a chance to. So do it by the Spirit the first time. Amen?
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Father, we thank you as we leave this place that the blood of Jesus is attraction to our times. We thank you even now that the angels of the Lord go before us. And the great host of heaven comes behind us. And the glory of the Lord overshadows us. And keeps us from hurt, harm, and danger. We thank you that our vehicles will not malfunction. We thank you now that no sniper, no murderer, no rapist, no thief can in any way violate us mentally, emotionally, or physically. We thank you that even as we drive home, that Father, we have this message on our minds.
Yes, Jesus.
Thank you now. Hallelujah. When we arrive to our destinations, then all things are well. When we lay our head down in our bed tonight, we'll reflect on this word. And we'll say it again, God, you did it. Not by might or by power, but you did it by your Spirit. Help us to live this Spirit life. Help us to walk this out. From our bedroom to the boardroom to the showroom. Wherever you lead us and guide us, help us to live this Spirit life out. No one in there but us. No one in there in that room but us. But help your nature to emanate from us in such a profound way that our presence is demanded upon. That people invite us just for our presence. God, we thank you. That we will be your witness. Your dunamis power lives in us.
Yes.
Now, Lord, we thank you that we will allow him to come from the back of our bus to actually steering our lives, actually navigating us through life's tempestuous journey. We thank you now, and we do give you praise. Bring us back at the appointed time for your glory. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name. And the people say, amen.
Amen.
Come on, give